I'm Jill Andrews. I'm currently president of the Society of Antiquaries. When I was invited to explore one of the items in our collection, I decided that what I'd like to look at is the mace. This is something I handle every week, but something I didn't know a huge amount about, and it's been really interesting discovering why we have a mace and what the history is which lies behind it. This rather splendid silver mace was given to the Society in the early 20th century by one of its fellows, Colonel Croft Lyons. And by tradition, it sits in front of the President at every meeting here at Burlington House, and it's held over the shoulder of the President, like this, when new fellows are admitted. This is in fact the third mace to have been in the Society's possession. The first mace we owned is this mace here, which was given to the Society in the early 18th century. And you can see very clearly that this mace shows its origins as a weapon of war. And this is iron and gilded and is dated to the early to mid 16th century. It's European. And as you can see, it would have been capable of doing a pretty vicious blow to anyone who encountered it. The fact that this was given to the Society in the early 18th century is interesting because I think it was meant to symbolise something at a time when the Society was still quite peripatetic. Like a lot of early clubs and societies in London, we were meeting not in established rooms, we were meeting in the Mitre Tavern just off Fleet Street. And so if you imagine this mace laid in front of the President, I think would have given an air of dignity and indeed sobriety in a place usually associated with conviviality. And also, it would have indicated the commitment of the early fellowship to be taken seriously as a learned society for the study of antiquarianism. And in fact, they met that goal in the later 18th century because they then got permanent rooms in Somerset House. And there was great debate when they moved to Somerset House as to whether or not this mace was really splendid enough to be used in the glorious new rooms at Somerset House. And in fact, it was discussed and put to a vote. And in the end, it was decided that they would continue to use this mace, which had in fact belonged to the very first president. So it was imbued with some antiquity. But it should be refurbished and re-gilded. And so that's what happened. It might not look like it now because the gilding is very worn, but it was improved and it continued to be used and laid in front of the President until the early 19th century, when once again, whether or not the mace was splendid enough to bestow status on the Society, came up for discussion, and it was decided that this time that regilding and refurbishment wouldn't do, and that a replica should be made. And this is the replica mace that you see here. This is very, very gilded indeed, and continued in use until the early 20th century. And in fact, it's still used today. When meetings are held outside Burlington House, this is the mace that the President travels with. By the early 20th century, fellows were worried once again, was this mace adequate to symbolise the status and authority of the Society? And it's decided that this time, a new mace, a brand new mace, should be commissioned. And this is the mace, which we started with, that was commissioned. There was some discussion within the Society as to whether or not, as to the design, and whether or not fellows should participate in that decision. But in the end, the decision was taken away from them by the generosity of Colonel Croft Lyons, who said he would like to donate it to the Society. And so the difficult decision of exactly the design, what it should contain, was left entirely to Colonel Croft Lyons. And you can see that this is a very splendid ceremonial mace. It has the arms of the Society on the top, and around the edge is the SA of the study of the Society of Antiquaries. On the top, it records the fact that Colonel Croft Lyons was donating on the outside are the names of the officers at the time. So we're now another 100 years on, but I think there's no question that this mace will continue for many years to come.